It's Amberly Snyder, and I'm 22 years old, and I live in Elk Ridge, Utah.
Amberly was so gifted with horses that, like, it was amazing to watch her.
At 3 years old is when I started riding, but I would go set up cones on my little pony, and I would do the barrel pattern with cones. It was at 8 years old that I decided, this is what I'm doing. I just remember that I got on a horse and that was where I was supposed to be.
When she's on her horse, that's when she is the happiest.
I'm making every run count. You know, ended up coming out with that world title that not everybody gets to say they get, especially in the all-around. I left with the finals and the world all-around titles. So between my saddles and my buckles, I have 7 saddles that I've won, and I have 72 buckles. And I was just gonna rodeo for the next year. I'm gonna go to college that fall, but that was my whole plan. And definitely did not go as planned.
So I answered the phone from my dad, and I could tell, something was wrong in his voice, and he just said, "Where's your mom?" And I just handed the phone to my mom. First word out of her mouth was just, "What?" And just, that was it. And she just fell to the ground and just started crying.
I pull my map out, I grab it from, it was on the passenger seat. I grab it and I pull it up and I'm looking at it right here, and I look up and I'm fading over. So I grab my wheel and my truck just starts sliding across the road. My back tire caught the dirt on the side of the freeway and my truck just instantly jerked totally sideways. I just closed my eyes and of course this is happening in an instant, and I will never forget just the banging and crashing that I'm hearing from my truck. And I just felt myself pick up and leave my truck. And I could hear it keep rolling, and I hit a fence post on the side of the road, and it hit me across the stomach. And my whole body just folded in half around it, broke it off, and carried it another 20 feet.
And that's like what broke her back.
And so I moved both my fingers, and then I looked down to move my toes, and nothing happened.
Thinking if she was still gonna be alive. And just, you know, how close me and her were was tough. Just because, I don't know, she was like my best friend.
I dialed my dad's number and I said, "Dad, I got in an accident. I can't feel my legs." He said, "Are you paralyzed?" I said, "Dad, I don't know." And I told him, I said, "Just call, like, you need to call Mom and tell her."
He handed me the phone and said it was Dad. And Corey said, "Em's been in an accident and she can't feel her legs."
My mom told my brothers and they started looking, flipping through all these books to try to find like hospitals of where she was. And when they contacted and got a hold of where she was, then my mom was on the road with her friend up to go to Denver.
My mom had, in 10 minutes was out the door, already driving to meet her.
I walked around to the driver's side, her hair, there was a big piece of her hair hanging out the door. And so I looked at that and I said to Stacy, I said, she went out this way.
So I'm laying there on that table. A doctor walks in. He started talking about being paralyzed. So I said, "Hey, what are the chances of me feeling or moving my legs again?" And he says, "Slim to none, but more than none."
I just remember the doctor coming up and asking me if I was her mom. And I said, "Yeah," and he said, "I'll show you in the x-ray. There's nothing, it can be done. This is a permanent thing." And I just remember kept saying that, "You don't know my Amberly." And then I just said, "Just take me to my girl." I had put my head down on the bed. And I was just sobbing, trying to be quiet because she was asleep. In her hand, she just reached over and put her hand on top of my hand because I thought she was asleep, and yet she knew how hard it was. I remember she said, "Mom, you're going to be so mad at me." She said, I just took off my seatbelt. said I had it on the whole time and I just took my seatbelt off.
And that was the first time that I broke down and cried because I told my mom, you know, this one mistake has cost me my legs. The nurse comes in and says, you know, here's your schedule for tomorrow. This is when you're going to be therapy. This is what your plan is. And let's make some goals of what you're going to do. And I'm like, that's easy. Walk, ride, rodeo. When I did come home, I convinced my mom and told my doctor I'm getting on and got back on. And that was one of the hardest days of my entire life. My family, my friends are all standing there, all smiling, all so excited I'm back on. And inside, I am like dying. It just crushed me. And I came home that day and I said, I'm done. This is it. I'm going to school. I'm not riding anymore. Sell my horses. And then I sat there and I thought, who are you kidding? You know how much you like doing this. Figure out what you have to do to get back on. So I took my saddle in. My mom didn't even know. I went and drug my saddle out of the trailer, loaded it in my truck, and drove it down to the people and said, this is the problem. I need to figure something else out. And so we put another strap on it, and I got it back. So going from the first time getting on that I was so devastated to that day, it's completely different.
I needed something else because my legs were just moving. And at first my horse just thought I was like kicking and just couldn't figure out what I was asking him. So then that's when we figured out those pieces.
I mean, just the story started getting out was when I hit the 5,000 friends and then somebody's like, you know, I had a couple people, well, you need to make a fan page. And I'm like, oh my gosh, you're really putting yourself on the line when you make a fan page because you're like, people are either not going to like you and you're going to look really dumb, or they will like you and then it's okay. And when you have people write, you inspired me, or you changed my life, or you motivated me to keep going, is when I realized, oh my gosh, like I really can change people's lives with this. I'm 22. I'm not going to postpone living my life until I'm walking and then hope to live it, because I don't know when that'll be.
22-year-old Amberlee Snyder's story is one of triumph over tragedy, and it all boils down to the fact that success comes once you determine you'll never give up.
When people give me opportunities, I choose to take them. You guys can do that too. So I challenge all of you that no matter where you are in life and no matter if you get knocked down, to get back up.
It's different now. I mean, when I get on the back of a horse, the love that I have for it, I didn't think could get any bigger, but it has. Because now when I get on a horse, I get to leave my wheelchair at the trailer, and I get to have my legs back because my horse is now my legs. And so I love it so much more. Because now it's like my freedom. Or that's the reason I would want to share my story, is so that people can look at this story and say, okay, if she was able to keep going, then I can keep going. No matter what I'm going through, I can overcome it.
But make a plan for your life and do everything you want to accomplish that. So, thanks for letting me come speak.